हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। नाउ मेनी टाइम्स वी नीड टू नो द हाइट ऑफ द टावर और अ बिल्डिंग और यू कैन से अ ट्री। ओके, और सपोज यू हैव टू फाइंड एनी ऑब्जेक्ट, ओके, विच इज एट अ पर्टिकुलर डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम योर डिस्टेंस, दैट कैन ऑल्सो बी फाउंड आउट यूजिंग द ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। ओके, नाउ we cannot measure them actually, but we can find them with the help of the trigonometric ratios. Now we have studied six trigonometric ratios, which is sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosec, sec, cot theta. Okay, now for the purpose of the calculation of any distance or height, we draw a rough sketch to show the given information in the form of problems. Okay, now trees, hills or towers are the vertical objects, so we shall represent them in the figure by the segments which are perpendicular to the ground. Okay, so you know that trees, hills and as well as towers are basically perpendicular to their ground. Okay, so we shall consider it as a segment that is perpendicular to the ground. Okay, also we should know that we will not consider the height of the observer, and we shall normally regard observer's line of vision to be parallel to the horizontal level. Now what is the observer line of vision? Now that I am going to explain you here. So basically we have some terms related to the trigonometry, that is known as the line of vision, line of angle of elevation, angle of depression. Okay, so I am going to explain you what is a line of vision, angle of elevation and angle of depression with the help of the diagram. So the first term that we are going to study is the line of vision. Now that's a very simple concept. So suppose that there is an observer at a point A, okay, and this observer is looking at an object present at B. Okay, so the line of vision will be connecting a segment from point A to a point B. Okay, so the line AB will be known as the line of vision. Okay, so basically this is an observer and this is an object. So wherever the observer will look at the object, that distance will be known as the line of vision. Okay, the next definition that we are going to study is the angle of elevation. Okay, so what is the angle of elevation? So suppose that the observer is at point A, okay, and the object is at point B. Okay, now this object is at a higher level than the point A. Okay, now so this observer is looking at this object, okay, and this is the horizontal line that I have drawn with respect to the observer. Okay, so what, when the observer looks at the object, it makes an angle with the horizontal line. It makes an angle with the horizontal line, and this angle is known as the angle of elevation. Okay, this angle is known as the angle of elevation because here the observer is trying to look at the object which is at a higher level than point A. Okay, now always you have to consider the horizontal line with respect to the observer. Okay, the object is at a higher level than A, so this angle will be the angle of elevation with the horizontal line. Okay, the next definition that we are going to study is the angle of depression. So in this definition, consider that your observer is at point A. Okay, the observer can be anyone, it can be you also. Okay, so whatever the person is given in your problem, that can be considered as an observer. Okay, so here the observer is looking at this object, okay, which is at a lower level than point A. Okay, so here the observer is looking at an object which is present at point C, and also I have drawn a horizontal line with respect to the observer. Okay, always we have to draw the horizontal line with respect to the observer. Okay, so in this case observer is looking at a lower level at point C, so the angle forms with the horizontal line, and this angle is nothing but the angle of depression. Okay, is known as the angle of depression. Okay, so the concept is very simple. So whenever the observer is looking at a higher level, so that will be the angle of elevation, and when the observer is looking at a lower level, then the angle will be the angle of depression. Okay, this will be very simple, and when you apply this actually in your problems, this becomes quite simple and easy to understand. Okay, so we are going to solve some sums based on this. Okay, so the first question here, it says an observer at a distance of 10 meter from a tree. Okay, so I'll make the diagram simultaneously so that you will be understanding very easily. So consider that here is your position of the tree, okay, and here is your observer. Okay, so I'll consider this as A and this as B. Okay, now the observer is at a distance of 10 meter from the tree. Okay, so this will be 10 meters, correct? I'll draw the line. Now the further information given here is the observer is looking at the top of the tree and the angle of elevation is 60 degree. So as you know that it is looking at the top of the tree, so I'll have to draw the line over here. Okay, and correct, so here the observer is looking at the top of the tree. This will be the horizontal line of the observer and this will be the angle of elevation. Okay, and here the angle of elevation is given here as 60 degree, correct? Further, it is also given that root 3 is equal to 1.73. okay, so we have to find this height of the tree. So this is the height of the tree. Once again I'll explain the diagram. Here is your tree, here is your observer. The distance of the observer from the tree is given as 10 meter and this observer is looking at the top of the tree. Okay, this is the top of the tree. Let us consider this as C. Okay, and the angle of elevation, because it is looking at the top of the tree, so here it will considering the angle of elevation because the top of the tree is at a higher level than the point at A. Okay, and the angle of elevation given here is 60 degree. Okay, so we are done with the diagram. And also you know that the tree will be perpendicular to the ground, so here you have to consider the 90 degree. Okay, now after drawing the diagram you have to consider the terms, that what are your terms regarding this. So basically BC is the height of the tree. Okay, so let us consider this as H. okay, so I'll write let AB is equal to H is equal to height of the tree, correct? Further you can say that here it will be BC. okay, further you can say that AB is the distance of the person or the observer from the tree. Okay, so this will be AB is the distance of observer of from tree. Okay, so distance of the observer from tree. Okay, now this is your angle 90 degree. Okay, so let us write angle ABC is equal to 90 degree. Okay, now since we got to know that this is a right angle triangle, so let us consider the triangle. Consider triangle ABC, angle ABC is equal to 90 degree. Okay, and let us consider the trigonometric ratio, which is tan. Okay, now why tan, I'll let you know. Okay, so this is your angle, this is the opposite side with respect to this angle, and this will be your adjacent side and this will be your hypotenuse side. Okay, now we have to find the height of the tree. So height of the tree is just the opposite and we have been given with the data of this one. Okay, so basically we have got only two datas, that is height of the tree and the adjacent side. Okay, so the only ratio that gives the relation between the opposite and the adjacent is the tan theta. So I will write tan of 60 degree, tan of 60 degree will be opposite upon adjacent, opposite upon adjacent. So this will be CB upon AB. CB is nothing but H and this is nothing but 10. Okay, now tan 60 is nothing but root 3 is equal to H upon 10. So H will be equal to 10 root 3, Further, root 3 is given as 1.73, and when you multiply this, this comes out to be 17.3 meter. Okay, so the height of the tree comes out to be 17.3 meter. Okay, so here we have got the answer, that is nothing but the height of the tree is equal to 17.3 meter. Okay, now the problem was very simple. Okay, so let us move on to the next question. Okay, now let us start with the second question. Here it is given as, to find the width of the river, a man observes the top of the tower on the opposite bank, making an angle of elevation of 61 degree. Okay, so here you have to understand that we have a river, okay, and we have to find the width of the river, okay. And the man observes the top of the tower on the opposite bank, making an angle of elevation of 61 degree. When he moves 50 degree backward from the bank and observes the same top of the tower, his line of vision makes an angle of elevation of 35 degree. We have to find the height of the tower and the width of the river. Okay, so now let us draw the diagram. So consider that this is your tower. Okay, let us name it as A and B. This is your tower. Okay, now the person is standing here at point C. Okay, and this is your bank. Okay, opposite bank. Here it is saying that a man observes the top of the tower on the opposite bank. So consider that the man is standing at point C, and this is your opposite bank of the man. Okay, making an angle of elevation of 61 degrees. So here this man is looking at the top of the tower. So let us draw the angle of elevation, which is nothing but 61 degree. Okay, further it is given that this person now moves 50 meter backward from the river. Okay, it is saying that he moves 50 meter backward from the bank. So let us take this point as D. Okay, this is nothing but 50 meter because it is given in the question. Okay, and now this same person is looking at the top of the tower. Okay, the same person is looking at the top of the tower. I have drawn this line of vision. Okay, now the angle of elevation now comes out to be 35 degree. Okay, so let us take this as 35 degree and join this all B, C and D. Okay, now this is your height of the tower, and let us consider the width of the river as x, because we have to find the height of the tower and width of the river. So let us take the height as h and the width as x. Okay, now let us write the further details, which is can be written with the help of the diagram. Okay, I have written here the statements, h be the height, x be the width of the river. Here I have written AB as the tower. Okay, now as you know that this tower will be perpendicular to the ground, so I have drawn the perpendicular sign here. So now let us consider the first triangle. Okay, only this much, that is A, B and C. Okay, so consider triangle A B C, where angle A B C is equal to 90 degree. Okay, now we have been given with the angle, but we have to think that what ratio you should use. Okay, since here we have to find the height and the width of the river, so this is your opposite side and this is your adjacent side. Okay, so I'll be using the one and only trigonometric ratio, which is tan. So I can write tan of 61 degree is equal to opposite upon adjacent. So this will be your adjacent side. This is nothing but h and this is your x. Okay, now the value of tan 61 is already given in the question. Okay, which is nothing but 1.80. Okay, and this is h upon x. So h comes out to be 1.80 times x. Let us consider this equation as first equation. Okay, now what further you can do here? Keep this h as it is, as equation number one, and let us take the another triangle, which is A, B and D, the whole triangle. Okay, now let us take the whole triangle, but here you have to take the angle as 35 degree because we are taking the whole angle, whole triangle. Okay. So now consider the triangle ABD. Still here, the angle ABD will be 90 degree. Okay. ABD will be 90 degree. Further, you have to take now, since there is nothing we have to find about the hypotenuse, so let's just forget about the hypotenuse. This is your opposite side and this will be your adjacent side. Okay, so according to the 35 degree, this will be opposite and this will be adjacent side. So I can write tan of 35 degree is equal to opposite, that is AB, upon adjacent is nothing but BD. Okay, now AB is nothing but H. But BD is nothing but in two parts, BC plus CD. Okay, BD is of made up of two parts, that is BC plus CD. So BC is nothing but X and CD is nothing but 50. Okay, right? Now, further what you can do here, the value of tan 35 degree, okay, value of tan 35 degree is already given in the question, which is 0.7. Is equal to h upon x plus 50. Okay, now this term will be multiplied here, so h will come out to be 0.7 times x plus 50, equation number 2. Okay, now this is also a value of h, this is also a value of h, so let us equate these two equations. Okay, so here we come out and we can write here as from equation 1 and 2, I can write 1.80x is equal to 0.7 times x plus 50. Okay. Now, further, what you can do here is you can just multiply throughout or on the both the sides by 10. Okay. So this will be 18x is equal to 7x plus 50. You can write the reason here, multiplying both sides by 10. Okay, so further, this will be 18x is equal to multiplying 7 inside, this will be 7x plus this will be 750, and 18 minus 7x is equal to 350. Okay, which will come out to be 11x is equal to 350, and further, you can write 350 upon 11. Okay. On dividing, you will get 31.82. Okay, now this x was the width of the river. Okay, so since all the length is given in the terms of meter, I will write 31.82 meter. Okay, further, the value of h was 1.80x, so I'll multiply this. So this will be 1.8 times 31.82. So when you multiply this one, you will get 57.28 meter. Okay. So we have got the height of the tower and the width of the river. Very simple. Okay. So I'll write the final statement as width of river is equal to 31.82 meter and height of tower is equal to 57.28 meter. Okay, so here you have understood this complicated sum that I have explained you with the help of the diagram and given you all the solution that you required for finding out the height and the width of the tower. Okay, now let us move on to the next question. So the next question given here is a ladder on the platform of a fire brigade van. So here you have a fire brigade van, okay, on which a ladder is placed and it can be elevated at an angle of 70 degree to the maximum. Okay, so it can be make an angle of 70 degree. The length of the ladder maximum can be 20 meter if the platform is 2 meter above the ground. Obviously this is a van, so it is 2 meter above the ground. Find the maximum height from the ground up to which the ladder can reach. Okay, so let me just draw the diagram and explain you. So here I have drawn a diagram, okay, where this is the platform of the fire brigade van, ओके एंड फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड इट इज 2 meters, ओके. द लैडर हियर इज मेकिंग एन एंगल ऑफ 70 degree, ओके, विद द प्लेटफॉर्म एंड द मैक्सिमम हाइट ऑफ द लैडर गिवन हियर इन द क्वेश्चन इज 20 meter, ओके. देन आई हैव ड्रॉन दिस परपेंडिकुलर हाइट, ओके, फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू द ग्राउंड बिकॉज दिस इज द लेंथ दैट वी हैव टू फाइंड, ओके, बिकॉज इन द क्वेश्चन इट इज गिवन दैट फाइंड द मैक्सिमम हाइट फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड अप टू विच द लैडर कैन रीच, ओके. सो बेसिकली वी हैव टू फाइंड ए सी, करेक्ट. नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दिस फिगर. सो हियर यू नो दैट दिस इज जस्ट अ स्क्वेयर, करेक्ट. दिस इज जस्ट अ स्क्वेयर, ओके. नाउ एज यू नो दैट ऑल द साइड्स ऑफ द स्क्वेयर आर इक्वल, सो इफ इट इज 2 meter हियर दिस विल ऑल्सो बी 2 meter, करेक्ट. दिस विल ऑल्सो बी 2 meter. देन फर्दर वॉट यू कैन डू हियर इज टू फाइंड ए बी, ओके. नाउ टू फाइंड ए बी वॉट यू कैन डू हियर इज यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस हाइट इज परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेटफॉर्म. दिस हाइट विल बी परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेटफॉर्म एज वेल एज टू द ग्राउंड, करेक्ट, ओके. So you have to find the length of AB by using this triangle, that is A, B and E, where it is the angle of elevation is given here is 70 degree, okay, and the height AE is given as A 20 meter, okay. So now let's just write some statements from the diagram. So here I have written AB be the height from the platform up to which the ladder can reach, okay. And this ED is the height of the platform from the ground, okay. Now the total maximum height from the ground up to which the ladder can reach is the AC, okay. So let us write one more statement, okay. Now I have written this statement, this also, okay. Now you have to understand that I have written this one perpendicular because this height will be perpendicular to the platform, okay. Also this platform or your van, okay, will be perpendicular to the ground, okay. So this will also be 90 degree, okay. Now let us prove this one, okay. Consider B E D C, a quadrilateral B E D C, okay. Since this is 90 degree, this is 90 degree, this will be 90 degree, and the remaining angle will also be a 90 degree, okay. So basically this will be a square, okay. Let us take this as a square because from the diagram itself you can understand that this is a square and not a rectangle, okay. Now further you can write that ED is equal to BC, okay, because this height will be same, okay. I can write here this is 2 meter, okay. So ED is equal to BC is equal to 2 meter, okay. So now we have to just find AB. So let us consider the upper triangle, which is triangle AEB, where angle ABE is given as 90 degree, okay. Now here what trigonometric ratio that we should use here. So you have to understand that this AE is opposite to the 90 degree, so this is hypotenuse, okay, and the relation or the trigonometric ratio that gives the relation between the hypotenuse is the sine and cos, okay. But here we have to find this height, that is AB, which is the opposite side of 70 degree, okay. So we have to find the relation between the opposite side and the hypotenuse. So the opposite side and hypotenuse is given by the ratio, which is sine, and here we have an angle of 70 degree, okay. So this will be opposite upon hypotenuse, which is AE. So opposite is AB, hypotenuse is AE, and further AB upon the value of AE is given as 20 meter, okay, is given as 20 meter, and the sine of 70 degree, sine of 70 degree is given in the question, which is 0.94 is equal to AB upon 20, okay. So further we can write AB is equal to 0.94 into 20, okay. So this will be 18.8 meter, okay. This will be 18.8 meter, So the total height will be, we have already found out the value of AB, which is 18.8 meter, and we have 2 meter extra. So basically the maximum height, which will be AC, and AC can be written as AB plus BC. Okay, so I can write here as maximum height is equal to, AC is equal to AB plus BC, which is 18.8 plus 2, which will give you 20.8 meter. Okay, so we have got the maximum height, which is 18.8 meter, and this was your answer. Okay, so the maximum height from the ground up to which the ladder can reach is 20.8 meter. Okay, so the question was very simple. Once you draw the diagram, the question becomes quite simple and you should understand what trigonometric ratio you should use. Okay, now let us move on to the next question. Okay, now the next question given here is, while landing at an airport, a pilot made an angle of depression of 20 degree. Okay, so suppose you have a plane over here. Okay, and this is your horizontal line. Okay, now the pilot made an angle of depression of 20 degree. Okay, so the plane was coming at an airport and it made an angle of depression, which is 20 degree. Okay, now further you have to understand that the average speed of the plane was 200 km per hour and the plane reached the ground after 54 seconds. So it started from here and this is your airport. Okay, this is your airport. So it started landing from this point and it finally landed here after 54 seconds. Okay, and that time the speed of the plane was 200 km per hour. We have to find the height at which the plane was when it started landing. Okay, so here we have to find this height. Okay, we have to find this height when it started landing. Okay, so let's just draw this line. Now you know that this line is a perpendicular because the height is always perpendicular to the ground. Okay, and this was the question finally. Okay, so let us name it. So let us take this as D, let us take this as A, B and C. Okay, now according to the figure you can see that this AD and BC line, these two lines are parallel to each other. Okay, and AC is a transversal. Okay, AD and BC are parallel to each other and AC is the transversal. So DAC and ACB will be alternate angle. Okay, so basically this angle and this angle will be the alternate angle and it will be equal. So this 20 degree will come out here because of the alternate angles. Okay, I will write the explanation further. Okay, so we are done with this. We have to find the AB. Okay, this was the height at which the plane started landing. Okay, so now let us start this sum. Okay, so here let us write that AD parallel BC and AC is a transversal. So we can write that angle DAC congruent to ACB because of alternate angles. Okay, further we can write that if DAC is equal to 20 degree, then angle ACB will also be equal to 20 degree. Okay, now after doing this, we are going to use the formula, which is speed is equal to distance upon time. Okay, now this is your distance. Okay, so basically this is your the distance when the plane started landing and here is your airport. Okay, so this is your AC value and the time given is 54 seconds. Okay, now you have to understand here that the speed is in the form of kilometer per hour. Okay, and here we have been given with the time, which is in seconds. So when you divide it with 60, you get the time in terms of minutes. When you further divide it with 60, now you get the time in the terms of hours. Okay, so the time given here was in the form of seconds. So when I divided with 60, you get the time with terms of minutes, and after further dividing it with 60, you get the times in hours. Okay, so basically you have to divide your time 54 seconds by 60 into 60, then this time will be in the terms of hours. Okay, the speed given here is 200, and this is AC upon 54 upon 60 into 60. This whole term will get multiplied here, and further we can write that AC is equal to 200 into 54 upon 60 into 60. Now this 0 and 0 will get cancelled. Okay, further this will be 1 time, this will be 3 times. Okay, and this will be 9 times, and 9 upon 3 will be 3. So basically AC is nothing but 3 kilometer. Now the distance, this is nothing but the distance, so this will be in the terms of kilometer, because the speed is in the form of kilometer per hour. I'll write here kilometer per hour. So our distance is in the form of kilometer. Okay, now after doing this, we have to consider this triangle. Okay, we have got the value of AC, which is 3 kilometer. I'll just write it here, you don't have to write. Okay, and this is your opposite side. Okay, because this is the height at which the plane started landing to the airport, so this height we have to find it. Okay, so this is your hypotenuse, which is opposite to the 90 degree, and the only trigonometric ratio which gives relation between this height and the hypotenuse is the sine. Okay, so we are going to find the sine of 20 degree will be opposite upon hypotenuse. Opposite upon hypotenuse. Okay, so before writing that, let us write, consider triangle ABC. Angle ABC is equal to 90 degree, and after this you can write sine of 20 degree is equal to opposite, that is AB upon AC. We have to find the value of AB, and the value of AC is nothing but 3. Okay, further sine of 20 degree, the value of sine of 20 degree is given as 0.342 is equal to AB upon 3. Okay, so this will be AB is equal to 0.342 into 3. Okay, so after calculating this, you will get, this is 3 times 2 will be 6, 3 times 4 will be 12, 1 get carry over, and you will get the value as 1.026 kilometer. Okay, when in the terms of meter, you have to multiply it with the terms of 1000. Okay, so this will become 1026 meter. Okay, so I have given you the answer in the terms of kilometer and the meter. Okay, so this was it. The question was very simple, as I have said that once you draw the diagram, the question becomes very simple. Okay, so that's it for today, and I hope you have understood this concept. And also, subscribe to my channel, share it with your friends, and do not forget to like this video. Thank you so much for watching this video.